Flying Guala, you don't know what that is?
No.
Are you serious?
Yes. Yeah, it's cool.
Optional start, right?
You just roll. Oh, yeah.
Oh, whoa.
You guys want to do that one?
Yeah.
If we're going to do this, all right, don't kick anybody. You don't have a lot of room, so watch out when you roll, all right? Promise me you won't kick anybody. You guys have ever heard of the Bonomo brothers?
Yeah.
No? They were a set of twins. They were two-time national champions back in the day. And they, when I was your age, they taught me this at camp. I hit it in practice. I never really hit it in a live, like, spotlight match, I guess. But I hit it at Penn State in live at practice. Is that true? Does that count?
Yeah.
You can't say who. That's messed up. Don't do that. But I hit it. So I would do it, probably not on your toughest opponent ever, right? Not if you're in like a 2-1 match or something, but if you, yeah, maybe. That's at your risk, I guess. All right, I would do it when I'm like, I guess this would be the situation, like you're pushing the guy's head down, maybe you're cutting him, right? And he's not really like reacting, he doesn't want to stand up or something, right? So you're like, I just want to get another takedown. That's when I would hit it on this guy, all right? My leg that's closest to his head. So this one, when I would do a forward roll right now, I'm facing sideways. The leg that's closest to his head is gonna step over top. And I see a lot of guys do it this way. All right, that's wrong. Okay, this is the back leg. So forward leg, closest to his head, steps over. I'm just gonna kick him in the chest. That's gonna pull him through. My back hand just goes by his far ear. And my other hand just goes between his legs. I lock up the cradle like after I roll him through. Just focus on the forward roll first. So I just forward roll. Don't have the cradle locked yet. Okay, just kind of lock it on the way through. Right here, it's kind of weird because you got your leg in between and you got a cradle. Leg doesn't really do much. You kick him right in the thigh or something, you know, maybe. But it doesn't really need, it's just kind of there because it's the move. It doesn't really do anything. Please turn a little bit, yep. So yeah, again, you knew it from optional start too, right? So yeah, probably not as good because he's probably going to stand up if he's any good. But this one, this is where I would do it from. You cut the guy and you just won't stand up. And you're like, oh, I want to get another takedown. Flying Guadalajara, okay, you step over, hook his back, his neck, roll through, kick, catch the crate job, right there. Floss on him. Anyone need to see it again? Yeah? All right, one more time. So either way you roll, right, just think about getting the leg that's closest to his head over top. That one's stepping over. This back leg isn't really doing much. You're doing a straight forward roll. So I gotta tuck my head and roll. Right here, I'm gonna hook on the side of his head. His back hand goes between his legs. Spin a little bit, that way. Hand just going between his legs as I roll. Look, kick. That's a great job. Pretty sweet. Alright, if you guys get that in a match, send me a video on Instagram. But yes.
What's it called?
The Flying Guadalajara. Yeah. Yeah, it's pretty sweet. Hit it at your own risk. Hit it at your own risk, okay? Like I said, probably not your toughest match. But if you decide to hit it, that is your decision. Okay. I'm not telling you to hit it in your toughest match. If you're in the state finals and you hit this and you get pinned, okay, I did not tell you to do that. Have fun with it. Go.